Well, here's one example of that you mentioned in your book of a way that legal writers can ease their readers' burden. And you caution attorneys to pay careful attention when they structure their sentences, because a sentence that confuses or frustrates a reader at the beginning of the sentence typically will have no reader at all at the end of the sentence. Is that your experience in reading attorney briefs, that if you enter into a sentence that is poorly crafted and confusing, that possibly you just wind up skimming and going to the next sentence and hoping the writer is going to get it right the next time around?
I think that's right, Tim. One of the two things I think is going to happen in most instances when a judge or any reader struggles to understand what they have just read, one is they may just give up. Well, there are several scenarios. A second scenario is they think they understand, move on, but they are misevaluating what the argument is. They are confused, but they don't know that they're confused. And then the lastly is what happens, I think, more than the first two cases is the judge will, and I think most judges are genuinely trying to understand, they will go back and reread what they've already read. And when you do that, you've destroyed the momentum of your argument. And I just think that's poisonous to persuasion. So one of the things that I think differentiates really skilled advocates from less skilled advocates is an appreciation for wanting the reader to not have to pause or go back and reread what they have already read. Psycholinguists tell us that most readers, legal readers, non-legal readers, academicians, all readers will tend to process what they read with what they already know. And so one of the lessons that I think we can draw on as legal writers is to try to put old or familiar information before new information, because that's how readers will naturally and effortlessly process what we read. And so when we put new information and then really don't flag to the reader any signal to what we've already said, readers are forced to navigate directly between new pieces of information. And that may be well-crafted sentences, but it's counter to the way that our brain processes written language. And so it sometimes will impede the clarity of what we're saying, and in a way that's not necessarily apparent, that it's just, you know, poor word choice or anything like that. It's oftentimes not the case. It's just a lack of appreciation that readers struggle sometimes when you're navigating directly between new pieces of information.
Yeah, I find that can be very difficult, very difficult challenge in writing to make well-crafted sentences, paragraphs, and entire arguments that don't offer, require the reader to absorb too much new information all at once, but also to do to be persuasive in a way that is not redundant, and you're not restating things over and over again because you are assuming that your reader cannot understand the basic gist of your argument. But in my experience, I found the only way to avoid that is to write the best you can, put the brief away for some time, a week or two if you can, and then come back to it. And then suddenly you're the reader, and you're no longer just the writer. You're the reader, because you've probably forgotten what you've written. And if you can absorb it and understand it as a reader, then maybe a judge can too.
I think that's wonderful advice.
Truly. Send it over to me, Tim. I'll clean it up for you. I'm happy to always happy to give a cold brief a read for you.
Yeah, but you're going to send me a bill, Jeff.
That's true.